Madam Speaker, I also want to address something that's been in the news, and that's the President's announcement yesterday that he will revoke California's waiver under the Federal Clean Air Act to set its own auto emissions standards. And this is something, as a native Southern Californian, that is near and dear to my heart. So many Southern Californians have had to endure poor air quality over the years, and this honestly is something that has never been partisan. Since the late 1960s, California has been able to set its own air quality standards, because the standards that we set when Ronald Reagan was governor of California in the late 60s actually preceded those standards set by the federal government. Clean air is not a partisan issue. This is absolutely ridiculous that the administration would want to go after California once again in this manner. So another thing to refute are the claims made by the president about vehicle safety and cost. Completely baseless. Fuel-efficient cars meet the same exact safety standards as any other passenger vehicle and have proven to be more cost-effective. And the auto manufacturers want to accelerate the transition to more electric vehicles, more sustainable vehicles. Everybody wants California to be able to have its own standards, with two exceptions: President Trump and Big Oil. Those are the only two exceptions. So it's pretty clear to see whose direction the president is taking when it comes to this decision. We also need to acknowledge that his decision here flies in the face of established climate science. Transportation is the largest source of greenhouse gas emissions in our country. And the science tells us that greenhouse gas emissions are driving climate change. So we should be doing everything we can to reduce those emissions from transportation. The Clean Air Act clearly gives California the authority to set its own emission standards. And this authority has been repeatedly confirmed by the courts, the Congress, and previous administrations, Republicans and Democrats alike. Again, this is not a partisan issue. Even the auto companies want to see this happen. So why are we still here? Why are we fighting over this ridiculous assumption by the president that he can unroll or roll back 5 decades of progress for cleaner air in California? We're not going to let it stand. I will do everything in my power as a member of Congress, as I know my colleagues will, and California will prevail.